Dear students, welcome to second lecture of eye cosmetics. In this lecture, we are going to study eyeshadows. So, eyeshadow, it is the cosmetic which is applied on the upper eyelid and the under eyebrows and around eyes to look eye more attractive. That means it is applied to the area surrounding to the eyes. So eyeshadows, it is available in different forms, that is powder compact, oil based stick types and pencil types. Most of the eyeshadows are also available in liquid form. These are oil based paste types or emulsion type, W by O or O by W type of emulsions. So eyeshadows that should require or that should meet certain quality characteristics. First and foremost, obviously the non-irritant and safety. Any product which is applied to the skin, it should be non-irritant to the skin and should be safe. It should not cause any side effect or it should not cause any skin irritation effect. Good skin adhesion and easy to apply. The eyeshadow should have good adhesive property, means it should not peel out after application to the eyes. It should be easy to apply. If within short application, it should be spread easily. It should not show oily luster after application. Means it should not show some oily stains or oily characteristics after application. And should not smudge by sweats or sebum. That means it should not get removed or it should not get concentrated at particular area due to sebum or sweat. Later comes to the formulation of eyeshadows. First one is cream eyeshadow. So cream eyeshadow may be liquefying cream or an emulsion. So when it comes to emulsion, the emulsion require oil phase, aqueous phase and emulsifying agent. So this formula contains all these ingredients. Oily phase, that is petrol atom, lanolin can be used in order to give some consistency. Then sparingly soluble ingredients can be used. Kerosene white can be used. Mineral oils can be used in order to maintain the viscosity. Spermaceti wax can also be used in order to give stiffness to the eyeshadow. And these ingredients are mixed with pigments, color pigments, in order to give coloring effect. We can have different use. So first of all, you should know what is use. Use means basic color. For example, blue, yellow, black, red, green, all these are use. That means if I consider blue, there might be different types of blues. That is sky blue, navy blue, dark blue, all these are shades of blues, but basic color is blue. Similarly, red is hue. In red we can have different types of shades, that is dark red, bright red. Pink is another form of red color, means if you add white color in red color, it becomes pink. All these are hues. So these shades can be available, these hues can be available in eyeshadow based on the type of pigments you are using. But remember, eye product should completely absence of coal tar color, because it might be dangerous to the health, it might be dangerous to the eyes, it might cause side effect or toxicity. This is the blue, ultramarine plus titanium dioxide. Means if you want to have different shades in blue, you can add titanium dioxide. Green, chromium green. If you want to change the shades, you can add titanium dioxide. Brown, violet. Emulsion type of eye shadow creams can be prepared by mixing pigments into emulsion and distributing them into base. This is the formula for emulsion based eyeshadow preparations. So here you can see 10 parts of pigments mixed with 100 parts of above base. So this formula is for base of eyeshadows, and if we add coloring agents in it, then it becomes eyeshadow, color eyeshadow. In order to manufacture the eyeshadows, first of all, we need to blend the pigments with petroleum jelly using roller mill. Then other fatty materials are melted in the pan and they are blended with petroleum jelly pigment mixture. And transfer the pigment mass to molten fats and stir well. After complete stirring, after homogeneous mixture, fill the product into container when it is in hot condition. Then allow it to cool. Your eyeshadow is ready for the labeling and dispatch. Next is stick eyeshadow. The previous one, it was cake eyeshadow. Now we are going to study stick eyeshadow. It is similar type of the eyebrow pencil or lipstick. These are stick eyeshadow. It performs the same function as anhydrous cream. Their formulation and method of preparation is similar to the lipstick. That means in order to prepare the stick eyeshadow, you need to melt all the base material separately. Then the coloring agents are blended with the base material, and after that these are filled into the lipstick or the stick eyeshadow container, and then these are frozen in order to get stick eyeshadow. This stick eyeshadow preparation contains higher proportion of waxy material with higher melting point. We need to ensure that the materials which are used in stick eyeshadow, they do not melt in room temperature or when it comes in contact with body temperature. So this is the formula for stick eyeshadow: castor oil, mineral oil, anhydrous castor oil, kerosene, carnauba wax, titanium dioxide, and different types of pigments. Manufacturing of stick eyeshadow: melt kerosene and carnauba wax together. Prepare the paste of pigments using oily components separately. Add both mixture together by using roller mills in order to form a homogeneous mixture. Remelt and pour it into mold in order to get stick eyeshadow. Then liquid eyeshadow. These are liquid in nature. The concentration of waxy materials used is less as compared to previous eyeshadow preparations. The pigments can be dispersed in a mixture of oils or in liquid emulsions. In such preparations, pigments generally get settled. That's why while applying the liquid eyeshadow, you need to stir the preparation before use. That's why the label should be used for such preparations with instruction: shake well before use. Formula is given in this slide: mineral oil 60%, corn oil 18%, propyl myristate 22%, pigments and preservatives. Manufacturing of stick eyeshadow already discussed. Powder eyeshadow. These are the powder materials and can be used with certain binding ingredients in order to compress this powder into container. The powder eyeshadow can be prepared either as loose powder or compressed powder. The formula is given in the slide. Above formula can be converted into compressed powder using binding ingredients. We can add certain binding ingredients which will form certain compressed mass after compressing the powders. These are the different brands available in the market with excellent eyeshadow qualities: L'Oreal Paris, Bobbi Brown, NARS Duo, Clinique Colors, Victoria's Secrets, Lorac, MAC Eyeshadow, etc., etc. These are certain novelties or innovations in eyeshadows. The eyeshadow stickers are available in the market, means you can simply add the stickers, or you can simply apply the stickers on the area where you want to apply the eyeshadow. You can press slightly and you can remove the cover, and you can have the design on the eyes. Then a digital eyeshadow with LED bulb, it is available but is not having great success in the market. So that's it for eyeshadow. For eyeliner, we will study next lecture. Thank you.